So this is the Technosat T888. The manufacturer also calls it a Plus Ultra. It's a digital satellite decoder, and it's only a DVB-S decoder. This is not DVB-S2, so it's a very old decoder. I bought this decoder in 2013. At the back, we have nothing much. It's not a HD decoder, obviously. It has a SCART output as well as composite output. It has also LNB in, loop out, together with RF in and loop out too. So you can use this for two televisions in one go, or rather three. You can use SCART, composite, as well as RF out. So let's check the remote. It's quite old. All the numbers have rubbed out, but I think I can still remember where the buttons were. So I still remember that this here is the menu button. So this decoder has what is known as a beeper, and we use the beeper in installation to help us find the satellite that we are looking for much easily. So to go to the beeper, go to antenna setup. And that's it. And when you are at antenna setup, make sure that your TV volume is working. So this beep means that there is no signal, and you can also see that the signal intensity is 39% and quality is 5%. It shows this even though I don't have a cable connected to the LNB in port. So let me connect the cable, and I'm going to show you how to use the decoder as a satellite finder. So now that you have the no signal beeper on your Technosat T888 decoder working, we're going to look for a frequency so that you can track the satellite that we want. So today I'm going to select Intelsat 20, which is at 68.5 degrees east. Let's select Intelsat 20. In case you don't know how to use Lyngsat.com website, I have another tutorial on my website linked in the description below, where I show you how to use this website. So we already know that the four digits over here mean that this is a C-band signal, but I don't want a C-band signal. I'm looking for a Ku-band. So we're going to scroll down until the digits start becoming four. Actually need five digits. Still C-band. That's still C-band. Now this is Ku-band. The five digits over here, like 10970V, that's Ku-band signal. So, but the beam on this website is South Africa. I'm looking for the Europe and Africa beam. So I'm just going to scroll down until I see Europe and Africa. That's what will work in my area. Still South Africa. Can see EU and ME and Central Asia. This beam. So that's South African beam. Now this, we have already started seeing Europe and Africa. So this will work in my area in Kenya. So I'm just going to track maybe one frequency that I need to track this satellite. We have to choose one. And I think I'm going to choose this one over here. 12682. The H there is the polarity. So I'm going to track this frequency on my decoder. Now we need the frequency and polarity. The polarity is horizontal H, and now let's check for the symbol rate over here. So the symbol rate can be found right here. That it's 27500. On my decoder, it might be a little bit different, but I'm going to show you what the difference is. I don't need the 3/4 I just need the 27,500. So we have our frequency. Let's go and check it on our decoder. It's time to set the frequency that we've checked from lingsat.com. Just go to transponder, select OK, and there's a very big list. You remember ours was 682H. So I'm just going to scroll down until I get 682H. That's 682, but the polarity is vertical, so it's not the frequency. Just going to keep on scrolling. That's the frequency that we want. Notice here that the symbol rate is saying 27,490. It's no problem. This decoder usually deducts 10 from the actual symbol rate. So I'm just going to go to the satellite dish. I'm sorry, I won't show you the setup outside, but I'm just going to set and increase the volume of this TV so that I can hear the beep when I'm outside. You will hear a different beep when I hit the signal. And also one more thing before I forget to mention, if you don't hear the signal, just go to system setup, come to other, and make sure that the beeper is on. If it's off, we are not going to be able to hear the beep sound. Like now, the beep sound is off. But if I go to system setup and select it on, then I come back to antenna setup, the beep is working. So don't forget to set the beeper to on. So now that I have the signal locked, I just need to tweak it a little bit and increase the signal quality. The very last thing you need to do is to adjust your LNB so that we can get the maximum signal. So I have a very good article known as Meaning of LNB Skew and What is LNB Tweaking and How is it Done. I wrote this article in 2014. It's still very relevant even now as I'm making this video in 2019. So I've included this website URL in the video description below. I'll be thankful if you check it out. And that's it, guys. Thank you for watching and goodbye.